Ira Epstein of Linn Associates with your morning flash update for this Wednesday. And we're at the 29th of January, 2020, in the time 9:20 a.m. Central Time. There is so much information today to deal with. It's not easy. Remember, you have the FOMC meeting coming out today. You're getting more updates on the coronavirus. And as you know, it keeps spreading and the numbers keep growing. We'll hear more about those hospitals that are going up in China and how fast they go up and where they're going to. Airlines around the world, they're starting to cancel. We are now at the point where we have also seen, and this is important, passage from human to human outside of China. So that is not the good thing. That means that it goes on. The other part of the news is just what the death toll really will be. Remember, this is more like a flu that is going around, and so far it's the elderly and the frail that have been hurt, and that's never a good thing, but those that are stronger seem to come through it. I know in Chicago we have a case here, and now they're chasing down all the people that that person might have come in contact with since it has taken on another characteristic of the spreading. I was watching how the gas masks, not gas, but the paper masks work. And those little surgical masks don't seem to do the job as much as you might think. You need the other type of mask that's more severe. We're still looking at the metal markets, not able to pick up. I keep watching copper. Copper is called Dr. Copper for a reason. It often gives you an inkling as to how the world economies are going, and it's really not lifting. When that lifts, I'll have a more positive attitude. The stock market rally, okay, you put up Apple and you get the market excited. There's a but and there's more earnings to come out. Today's Tesla day. The average volatility on this, if you look at the options, is 9.5%. Some people are thinking it could be over 11 today. If you take a look at the energy markets, they tried to rally. You have fallen 120 points here. You've given back a dollar a barrel here. Gasoline got up to 154.61. It's already up barely 20 cents. And you keep breaking down in the nat gas. Certainly not a good picture. You're putting bids into the bonds and notes again, and very flat markets in the grains. Traders are scared to take positions because you get a piece of news and it moves on you with this virus, and that's the problem. But let's go to the normal news and we'll take it the rest of the way, and there's a lot of it. You got the National Association of Realtors, pending home sales in December down 4.9%. They were looking for it up a point. It's a disappointment any way you look at it. December pending home sales year over year instead of month over month, that was up 4.6%. The prior was 7.4, so muted. Mortgage market numbers, okay, so we look at the index itself and it's up 7.2. We're seeing that the prior week was up 5.3. These are good numbers, so people are doing things with mortgages. That's good. The Commerce Department reported today that the goods trade gap jumped 8.5%. When I read into it, it appears to be more of a blip because it had been falling for the past 3 months. You can see here the details. Good imports surged 2.9%. Exports went up only 0.3. Retail inventories not surging. They were pretty much unchanged after declining 0.8 in December. And wholesale inventories dipped a 0.1 last month after gaining that 0.1 in November. The FOMC meeting that comes out at 1 o'clock today, what you focus on are these repo facility operations that are going on almost every day or every other day. While the Fed says it's not a form of QE, the fact is, when does it come to an end? They might tell us that they expect a surge in funds around tax time. I don't know. But we'll all be listening to that. As for looking for the Fed to raise interest rates or lower them now, I think that's pretty much off the table. They will be asked about the coronavirus and what they think the impact, and all they can do is say what the rest of us do. We have to watch, but it is a headwind. The European Union's going to outline its guidelines for the restriction of the high-risk 5G vendors, code word Huawei, from parts of members' network. You know that Europe, in terms of the UK, they went with parts of it for Huawei, but they claim it's non-vital parts. Tesla's going to announce its earnings. The U.S. Senate has 2 days of questions that begin today. The real question now is, Mr. Bolton going to be called as a witness or not? And does Mitch McConnell have enough votes to say yes or no on that? Right now, it doesn't look like it. In other words, Mr. Bolton might be called, but 2 days of questions, you don't know. The president is due today to sign the USMCA deal with Mexico. Canada has yet to ratify it. OPEC is already floating the idea of waiting and keeping these cuts in place until at least June. I've heard the end of the year, and they might even have to cut back production with what's going on with oil in China and the lack of companies opening. Now, on the positive there, Foxconn has already said that they will meet all of Apple's needs. They're not going to be affected by it, they say. And Ford announced it plans to resume auto production on February 10th. So these are positive signs that you're getting for those tires. If they can reopen the factories, the hit to the rest of the world, not as bad. But if the disease spreads, that can change on a dime, and you'll say, you know, people don't want to go out. They don't want to go into a big factory. They're going to get the flu. They're scared about it. ECB data released today shows the broad money supply called M3 went up 5% in December compared to the year earlier month. Now, if you don't know what M1, M2, M3 are, then what you should get is our futures trading kit. I created years ago a booklet when Paul Volcker was our Fed chair. And money supply was very important back then and the different parts of it that were moving through the economy. So if you'd like to learn when you're taking a look at our free offerings, you might want to sign up. I wrote an interesting paper. It's done as a brochure in it, and it just helps you with it. Another thing, you know, I got up today, for example, I'm recording at 5:30 in the morning now because I'm getting you plenty of ideas as to what's going on and what to not get caught up in the markets, and there's so much information coming, we're trying to work with it. Remember, I cover now 40 charts on the futures for you. I'm covering ETFs, not five, but maybe 20. In my spider ETF video that I record at 3:30 in the afternoon. Both of these videos, the ones that I'm talking about, my morning subscriber video and the subscriber for the spider ETF, you can only get if you get a user ID and a password. They will never be on YouTube. They're in a protected area on our website. And the reason for that is I'm saying buy here, sell there, do this, do that. I'm starting you up. See how this information, my traders have had it already all morning long. I give them specific points of entry. I've already read the European, the Chinese, Japanese news. I'm up to date, looking for what's going to happen today, and we discuss it in the morning. These are the markets in the futures update that I cover. This is the morning update there. And you can also swipe and get to the area you want. I make it very easy, and I did the same thing now in the spider ETF video. So time, I know it's important to you. You can go right to the areas you want, and they're highlighted just like I do here. You'll have the oil sector on the spider videos, the different currency ETFs that are there, everything that'll work out for that. How do you try them? I'm putting them together as a package for you to try. It's that simple. If you buy the morning subscriber video, you're automatically getting for the short period of time the spider video as well. $7.95 for the first 30 days. That's really for the morning subscriber video. I'm just throwing the other in. After that, it'll go to its own separate. In 30 days, you're going to have your own separate subscriptions to both. You can go to one or the other. You'll figure that out. It'll be $15 on the futures one. For every 30 days, you can buy a one-year subscription. We will do something similar in the spider, but right now you get to take a look at it free. Why not? And I think you'll find it interesting. How do you get it? And if you need more help, call my staff. You can go to our website. You'll see if you go to the word research, we have a whole section there about what I'm offering, and we can talk much easier than you read and walk you right through everything. But if you want to sign up for the futures one, we welcome you to do that. You're going to get the other automatically. Just go to research. You'll see how to sign up there. Do it and away you go. I'll see you this afternoon after the FOMC. You have a good day.